marks your hospitality because you are hospitable, that's right, but there is another thing because of which I feel very much at home, and that is this orange drink here, which is our national color. There was one occasion where I felt likewise at home, that was on the Orange March two years ago, I guess, yeah. In the lull of the IRA ceasefire, which was a very comfortable meeting. I was nearly converted to an orange man myself by some very friendly and outgoing orange man who had very little inhibitions to embrace other people in their group. Well, I should not go into details too much about this. What I want to do is explain how I met Paul. And I hope that in the course of what I'm saying, that it will become clear what kind of guy Paul really is. I have to start with somebody else, of course. 3 years ago, I went to a Bible college in America for retreat. And I'm one of the guys of the kind that needs glasses to read history, but there are also people who write history. And one of the people who write history is, at least at the Bible College in Berwick-upon-Tweed, is Diane Matchett, sister of the groom. And I did my best to understand her, to talk to her. It was even more easy to listen to her because she was talkative. The difficult thing was only to understand her, especially the punchline of her jokes. Well, I managed somehow, but after a few weeks, or I don't know exactly how long, she announced that her brother was coming along. So I prepared for something Diane-like coming. So I was amazed when Paul turned up. First I tried to listen to Paul. Well, that was impossible because Paul didn't speak. Then I tried to talk to Paul, but it was difficult as well because I didn't know exactly what to talk about. So, yeah, I was a bit at a loss what to do with this guy. But then Paul took over. We started talking somehow. It started with pool, playing pool. And then there was a missionary meeting going, but we didn't go, we went somewhere else. We went to the Helden Hill, a nice hill in the neighborhood, and there Paul started reciting his poems. And that was a very special experience, and there Paul really showed who he was and gave quite a different impression of himself. And that was the start of a friendship, a meeting of two people, but even a meeting of families. Which is, till this very moment, very special to me. So I'm very happy and honored that he invited me on his wedding. Maybe I should mention a few details more. If I forget to mention some, then it's your responsibility to remind me of some more. But after we have met, I went to Northern Ireland. But a bit later, my friend Bagamba from Zaire also joined me and to work on the apples. In the south of England, where I was at the moment, I told people, I'm going to Northern Ireland to pull apples. Oh, you mean to pick apples, they said. No, I said to pull apples, because here in Northern Ireland, you don't pick apples, you pull apples. While pulling apples, we learned another skill, and that is gathering apples. that's the most fine skill I've ever learned here in Northern Ireland, gathering apples. But still, I'm very fond of apple juice. Don't worry. Well, I want to finish with expressing my wish, Paul and Jennifer, that your marriage will be a good one, that you will take up each other's personality and do something good with it. And I think you are both quite capable to do it. Paul and I have shared a lot about life, about philosophy, psychology, and I think Paul is one who who wants to delve deep into a personality, and he wants to be delved into. And I hope that that will happen in the next, hopefully, many years. Thank you.